Argao is a town in southern Cebu, Philippines that is known for its rich cultural and culinary heritage. Among its major economic activity back then is the hinablon, or hablon for short, the art of hand loom weaving. Argawanans believe that this industry dates back to the pre-Hispanic era.
Ako ang lula.
Sadly, because of the decline in demand for both hand-woven fabric and the decreasing number of habloneras, hablon was almost considered a sunset industry.
Ni declined yun ang relevance of hablon to the point that I think there was only just one sitio, not even a barangay, one sitio in Argao that were left weaving.
This became the subject of a research study of graduate school students of Cebu Technological University, or CTU, in 2013. The researchers then suggested to create a community extension project out of the results of the study in 2014.
We called it Hablon sa Cebu to revive a dying industry, which we would like to pass on to generations to come.
CTU's first intervention was to help raise awareness and market hablon products by participating in trade fairs and engaging with partner agencies and institutions in the country. In 2014, a pageant called Dalagang Argawanon was launched in partnership with the local and provincial government, wherein they regained recognition, and in 2016, CTU received a grant from the Department of Trade and Industry in the form of 20 hand loom machines located at the shared service facility inside the school's Argao campus. These machines were innovated by the school students and teachers to make it more ergonomic for the weavers and to expand the hablon fabric from the original 36-inch maximum width to 60 inches. Along with the innovations in the hand loom machines came improvements in the weaving designs as the habloneras went through consistent skills training. Nearly 5 million pesos was also raised by CTU from its partner agencies from both the public and private sector to fund their marketing, product development, and capacity building activities. What then was feared to be a dying industry came back to life, and the descendants of the original habloneras chose to continue the beautiful tradition that their ancestors started.
We have now 20 weavers, and that means 20 families.
Sikad ato nakasugod ko, hablonry, wala may maglisod. Okay na kaya mong panginabuhin.
Aside from fabric, they were also able to create secondary products made of hablon such as bags, clothes, footwear, accessories, and home furnishings that are also on display at the showroom they built inside the campus. To improve the value of their products, they added hand painting, embroidery, and digital fabrication. This in return generated more jobs as they were able to hire more than 50 sewers and project finishers. Their products were further polished through the help of famous designers who became their industry partners, such as Kay Batikin and Debbie Palau of the Holistic Coalition of the Willing, or Holy Cow, who taught them how to ensure stricter quality control to widen their products' reach. Hablon sa Cebu then broadened to include home furnishings such as towels, table napkins, table runners, placemats, pillowcases, and even furniture.
So my first impression was it has so much potential. It was like something that could open doors actually to know so many people and could make livelihood for so many as well.
Usa ko ka proud nga hablonera kay daghan ko na kamauan dili kay sa sayon ra hasta sa lisod nga ako ang naagian nga hablon. Daghan pong nalipay sa among mga trabaho.
However, they were not exempted from the wrath of the pandemic.
Siyempre murag kuan nalungal naluya pod may mga kuan kay mao na bay ni amo ang ipanghuaag.
To help bring back the demand for hablon products, CTU passed a Board of Regents resolution to require their institution's graduates to wear a sablay made of hablon every graduation.
It provides continuous sustainable livelihood to our weavers and sewers, which is important to us.
Designers Debbie and Kay helped in creating the sablay's design, which included an embroidered badlit or the Visayan baybayin, which meant the self for a higher cause.
The sablay is a manifestation of what CTU would like to see in its graduates working for a cause greater than ourselves.
CTU hopes that with these policies and structures created, the hablon industry will live on even without them.
A genuine social enterprise. We cannot be here forever.
We realize also that sustainability is very important and institutionalization is critical to sustainability. I'm very grateful for CTU, you know, their system, that it has provisions and it has the people, the right people.
Ako, I have served my purpose as a teacher, but at the same time, I have also touched the lives of these women.